Hello and welcome to WPKlik's YouTube channel. A great new feature that came out with the Gutenberg WordPress editor is the gallery block. Like other features that the Gutenberg brought, this one is designed to make it easier to work in this platform. Specifically, the gallery block is meant to simplify the way we handle image galleries. Let's take a quick look at some of the basic operations and features of this new functionality. Gallery block's core function is to allow sharing of a group of images in a gallery's type format on your website. Before you add a new gallery, you need to either pick the images you want to use from your media library or to upload them from your computer. After you have selected images you want to use, click on Create a new gallery. Next, you can customize your gallery using the options such as Align or Change block type. This second option is particularly useful as it allows you to transform the gallery block into the image block, in which case all the images you have added will line up individually, one next to another. If you decide to add captions to your images, you'll be happy to learn that the gallery block allows you to add an individual caption to each image. Now, note that in the gallery block, you don't get to choose the size of the pictures. Instead, they change proportionally to the number of columns that you wish to have in your gallery. The biggest column number that you can put is the same as the number of pictures that you end up adding to your page or post. In other words, the number is infinite. Nevertheless, be mindful of the fact that after adding more than 6 columns, your pictures may appear smaller than you like them to be. If you plan to use images that contain different aspect ratios, like portrait or landscape, you can make sure that the crop images setting is on. This will ensure that all of your photos fit automatically within the column number you have picked. Just like in image block, gallery block also has a link to setting with 3 different options. You can display the image without any link, you can link to a specific page on your website, or allow it to open the picture file by itself. As for the edit option, this one allows you to remove any files you don't want to have in your gallery, or to drag and drop the items to rearrange them. These are some of the basic things you can do with the gallery block. We hope you found this tutorial helpful. For more information on this topic, check out the description and make sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel.